Hello's, welcomes back everyone, and Wolf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic, playing as Ciaphas Cain here, my Jedi Knight. And it was a large mix of emotions we had in the last part with the Meridian Complex Shipyard, and the return of Lord Scourge and our Padawan, Kira Carson. Who wished to let us know that they've been searching for Tenebrae's final terrible weapon. So, we are going to be heading back to Odessen. We do actually have quite a bit of mail, which I believe is due to us, well, saving the Meridian shipyard, of course, and returning to the warm embrace of the Galactic Republic. So, with that in mind, let's get ourselves over to Odessen first. Starting a fresh session here today. I did a fair bit of Star Wars The Old Republic yesterday with Ciaphas Cain.
Sure, have a look at what's available.
Oh, okay.
Until next time.
Throw a few things away. Excuse me. I think I already have, yeah, I have a couple of these Kral records already. I don't really need another. What's in this chest? Objective Meridian decoration. Oh, it's a Doth Malgus Holo statue. I see. And okay, that looks good. Anything new in the cartel market? Not really. Okay. Let's go check out our mail before we do anything else. From your good friend Veek of Harilda Wald. Things are running smoothly now that our little problem is out of the way. And that is good news for Veek, good news for Harilda Wald, and good news for any of our esteemed business partners, of course. The future is bright, all thanks to our mutually beneficial arrangement. If there's anything you ever need, you know who to call. It seems like the brothers have all but been wiped out on Mech Shah. I knew I liked that Padawan of Tau's. He's got potential. I'm not contacting you to entirely sneer at the poor Jedi. The loss of the brothers on Mech Shah will have wide-ranging effects on the Empire's labor resources. The brothers were rather zealous about their work, and the number of slaves they supplied to the Empire comprised an astonishing percentage of their forced labor operation. It will certainly take a toll on productivity at this quite critical moment. I thought you should know. Oh, we have a message from a Jisha Narlok. I just want to thank you for saving my dad. He told me that you were a hero on Mech Char. I know it's probably all in a day's work for someone like you, but my dad is everything to me, and I don't know what I'd do without him. Indeed, not to kind of spoil things that may come in the future if we choose a different path. But if you were to act as a double agent, we could have, well, Narlok could have met an unfortunate end back at the fueling docks. We have a message from General Dayrune. Ah, he sent this before we actually went over to the Meridian Complex. Oh, this is a message from the Supreme Chancellor. Commander, I cannot thank you enough for all you've done for the Republic. Without your aid, I doubt our reinforcements from Onderon and Mechshar would have ever arrived. And without them, we may have lost everything on Corellia. As it stands, the Republic is stronger than we have ever been in some time. We've already started driving the scraps of the Empire from our border territories. The future has never been brighter. With help from you and other strong leaders like Dayrune, Nostorol, and Tau, it feels like nothing can hold us back. Maybe I'll revise that statement as soon as the Senate instarting starts up again. But for now, things are looking good. We have a message from Tau here. I wanted to commend your judgment in the battle over Corellia. You may have gone against the plan, and maybe we didn't do as much damage to the Imperial forces as we could have. But you chose to put the lives of our civilians above destroying a few more ships, and you made the right call. You don't need me to pat you on the back or anything, but it's nice to see someone in your position care about the things that really matter. The things that separate us from the Sith. And then her Padawan. I finally had time to really think about what happened on Mech Char. I am glad you were there, but I am especially grateful that you called Tau, and I'm sorry I put our mission at risk. I was so overwhelmed with anger seeing no slavers. Letting my rage take control was wrong, even if it was against pieces of scum like the brothers. I don't want to do anything like that again. Talking with Tau, I've sort of found out that I have a lot more to work through than I wanted to admit. We have a message from Baron Cedrax here, of course. You likely know it, but saving the Meridian Complex, you protected what was potentially the most important technological advancement in Republic's history. The Republic was kind enough to furnish me with everything I needed, up to and including components salvaged from the Eternal Empire ships to create the shipyard, and it represents the bleeding edge of production technology. If my inventions here had been destroyed, I cannot conceive of how we'd ever stand a chance against the Empire, or how I'd win this year's Silver Quasar Award for excellence in engineering. Vice Admiral Narlok now. I regret to inform you that our prisoner from Mech Char, one Major Anri, has escaped. I ordered her imprisoned in the brig of the Aphelion III, the most heavily secured ship in my command. We still aren't exactly sure how the Imperial wriggled her way out, but I've ordered a thorough investigation. I'd be impressed if I weren't so livid about the whole thing. It is no simple matter to break out of a ship like that and disappear into nowhere in the middle of the fleet. And last but not least, of course, one from Lana Benico. I have begun the laborious process of integrating our operations with the Republic. Funny how bureaucracy is a nightmarish tangle whichever side you are on. We have some housekeeping to attend to, particularly around selecting a senator to represent us. We don't need to choose immediately, but you should start giving it some thought so that we can vet our candidate fully. I admit I'm reluctant to give up our independence, but it will likely benefit us to have greater access to Republic resources. Despite my reservations, I will trust in your judgment. I suppose I'll get to menace a great many more innocent Padawans now. I do look so forward to doing so. 2 moments. Ah, sorry about that. Downside of starting a new series. Starting a new session, especially this early in the morning. So, let us go catch up with Kira and Scourge. What have they been up to for? We know we spent 5 years in Carbonite. And I'm guessing we may have taken a year between Knights of the Fallen Empire and Knights of the Eternal Throne. So 6, possibly even 7 years have passed.
Still hard to believe that you're both back after all this time.
To be fair, we weren't the ones who disappeared in the first place.
True. We weren't the ones who charged away aboard an exploding ship.
All of those years without you. It wasn't easy. I was a nervous wreck wondering what had really happened to you. I guess what I'm saying is, never worry me like that again, okay?
I've waited a long time for you to come back to me, Kira.
We have a lot of catching up to do, don't we?
Why don't you tell me what's been going on?
As I told you on Carrick Station, Tenebrae's last gruesome weapon. He sought immortality, but only his endless spite survives now. In your absence, I received guidance. From an old ally. The path to our enemy's ultimate death was unfolding, and we had a crucial part to play. Tenebrae hid his original body where no one could harm it. As long as that body remained in stasis, the galaxy's greatest evil could never truly be killed.
Unless we destroyed Tenebrae, the fight against Valkorian would never really be over.
Since Valkorian is gone, I assume you succeeded.
We did. As we later learned, we destroyed his first body just as you purged the last vestige of his twisted spirit from your mind. That is when his final weapon was unleashed. A Sith ritual, carved into his very flesh, unleashed an ancient plague from every molecule of his decaying corpse.
We were both knocked out cold, comatose for more than a year. Satil Shan was the one who finally pulled us out of that nightmare. And started a new one.
Since we had both been vessels for Tenebrae's power in the past, we were both protected to a large degree. Like a vaccine. But Satil had no such protection. Nor did any of her followers. Within days, they were all laid low, trapped in a nightmarish slumber. In helping us, they unknowingly doomed themselves.
This ritual... What can you tell me about it?
Nothing. We lost consciousness even as we felt it taking shape. The infection is worsening, There is a darkness growing among the afflicted.
We can feel their minds connecting, communicating. We're afraid they might be merging somehow.
Merging into what? Another Valkorian? Is this plague bringing him back somehow?
It's too early to make that conclusion. Whatever it is immensely dangerous. We must stop it.
How?
We loaded Satil and all of her followers onto a transport to keep them quarantined, along with a few med droids to tend to them. The transport is programmed to fly a random course through unsettled sectors of the Outer Rim, all weeks away from civilization. I can send a signal to alter the course, bring it to another empty system that's closer so that we can meet it in a shuttle.
We board the ship and connect our minds with yours through the Force. Together, we will face this entity and purge it from existence. And if we cannot purge it, then we destroy the transport and hope we've ended the old monster's schemes forever.
Send the signal. If what you say is true, this thing could be getting stronger by the minute.
I'll send the signal right away. It'll be a while before the ship comes back into range. Scourge, did you...?
Yes. There is a private matter we should discuss. The sooner the better.
Okay. A private matter. We should have maybe spoken to Scourge and Kira before we ended the last part of the series. Oh well. It seems like we're now getting ready for the new content, whatever that may be. If that's the case, why don't we just wind things down, make this a short part of the series once again, and attend to a couple of private matters? It seems both Scourge and Kira would like to have a word. Yeah, Scourge would like to have a moment of our time outside of the chaos that comes after battle. Find him at our Force Enclave.
What you've built here is no small feat. You've done well for yourself, destroying the Emperor, claiming his throne. You have accomplished even more than I'd hoped for.
I have my sights on much more than just Valkorian's old chair.
Spoken like a Sith. You continue to impress me. There is something else I wish to speak with you about. The Emperor's destruction had a profound effect on me. Something beyond the disease his death unleashed. My immortality is gone. For 300 years, I thought I would be content to accept my end, should the time come. But my new mortality has unforeseen effects.
Like what exactly?
Emotions and sensations I'd long forgotten have taken hold again. I am compelled to fight for something I believe in. And I have realized how important to me our old crew had become. Especially you, Jedi. I feel the need to remain by your side, and I don't know what to make of it. But I would do anything to keep you safe. Do you understand?
The most important part of life is the bonds we form. You finally feel that?
It will take some getting used to. But I'm already beginning to like it. I cannot predict what the future holds. But I will be here to help you face it.
And I believe Lord Scourge has now rejoined us as part of our alliance. Indeed. After destroying the Sith Emperor's original body, Lord Scourge has returned to fight by your side once more. With everything that's happened, it's nice to finally feel like I have a moment to catch my breath. But now that I've got a break, all I can think about is how much we've got to catch up on. I know how busy you are, but if you need a break, come find me in the Force Enclave.
Nice digs. Sure beats where Scourge and I stayed for the last few years. You know, I wasn't exaggerating earlier. I really would have torn through the galaxy to get you back. Even stole a ship to rescue you. Till Scourge talked me down. For a Sith, he's kind of a wet blanket. Point is, nothing felt right without you. Life just lost its color, you know?
I'm sorry I put you through that.
No, I'm not trying to make you feel guilty. I'm trying to tell you how much I love you. Every night I went to sleep missing you. And then I woke up missing you. Even after all these years, it's never gotten any easier. But now you're finally here, right in front of me, and I'm trying to be a good Jedi and control my emotions, and it is killing me. Do you know how badly I want to kiss you? Pretty bad.
This choice will resume your romance with Kira Carson.
I love you, Kira. And I'm not holding back anymore. The Force will understand.
Thank the stars. Feels like the future is finally starting. And we're in it together. Till the end.
And indeed, the Padawan does indeed return. After all these years apart, seeing Kira again has rekindled your feelings. You are together once again. More than allies who fight side by side, but as two people who love each other. We'll get ourselves back up and over to
patience.
The Alliance landing. And there we will take a break. We haven't had much conversation and much story progression in this part, but it still feels like we got a little bit done. Fair bit of mail actually checked off as well. But when we come back, unfortunately, events will start going forwards once more, and not everything is going to go for the better, as we're soon to discover. Thank you all for joining me with even more Star Wars The Old Republic. As always, feel free to leave a comment if you so wish. And hopefully I'll see you for even more next time. Until then, take care. Bye bye now.